بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها، لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به، واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا، أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. تون دكتور محاذير محمد، ladies and gentlemen, members of the conference, I would like to greet you all with a greeting of kindness and human brotherhood. It is my pleasure to convey to you the greetings of the people of Iraq and their valiant resistance of all different attitudes, patriotic, national, and Islamic. As I feel excited and gratitude coupled with happiness to give us the opportunity to talk to you about the situation in Iraq and the consequences of occupation and its massive destruction to all aspects of life, politically, economically, socially, and morally. I must substantially thank the great warrior brother, Dr. Mahathir Muhammad, for inviting us to attend this important conference, which aims to adopt positions supporting the rights of peoples in freedom and dignified life, and to achieve sovereignty and national dignity, and condemning the occupation and decriminalize its actions and expose its projects so as to enhance peace and stability in the world. Greetings to you all, to the brothers in Malaysia, people, government, and leadership. Ladies and gentlemen, the U.S. occupation of Iraq, as it is known to you, has failed in the military side, as well as its political process, which is also suffering from confusion and fissures due to political, financial, and administrative corruption that haunt its branches, and this is recognized by its main parts. All this was done by jihad and resistance of the people of Iraq that have caused the heaviest losses in the largest empire of evil and aggression. One report issued by the Ministry of the Veterans say that the number of the Americans wounded in the war, هذه خسائر الحرب بالنسبة للأمريكان. The number of the Americans wounded in the war in Iraq has reached 224,000 injuries, resulting from 164,000 military operations. The ministry said that one of every seven wounded was among the dead, and let us know that the occupiers' death reached, according to this statistical limit, to 33,315 soldiers, and this is close to the estimates and the statistics of all the resistance factions. Despite the contrast in statistics from a center to a center, even if we accept the U.S. administration official statistics that said the amount of 4,500 dead and 52,000 injured people or soldiers and thousands of suicide bombers and people living with psychiatric and mental disabilities, this will be more than one-third of the U.S. military in Iraq. At the same time, the wars caused because of the large attrition of the occupation forces. By the latest statistics, $1,800 billion, and the Stiglitz Nobel laureate in economics with Linda Belms, a researcher in the economy, indicate in their important book, The Three War Trillions, that the overall cost of the war, including the infrastructure of the U.S., military will reach the limits of 3 to 5 trillion at the end of this war. We say that these indicators, which reflect the historical achievement of the Iraqi resistance, was the basis of their decision to schedule a withdrawal from Iraq, as decided by the criminal Bush, and that pushed him to find a mechanism to get out of Iraq, according to what is called a security agreement, in order to say to the Americans and the world that he has done and achieved U.S. interest in Iraq and established the so-called democratic government loyal to the United States in Iraq. The strategy to withdraw from Iraq, which began on 30 June by withdrawing from the cities, came on as the facts mentioned above, despite that the formal withdrawal did not alter the number of the U.S. troops, since they are still in their locations, which are mostly in the heart of Iraqi cities or close to them. They have the control on the land and air, in addition to the political, economic, and military decision. We can say that this achievement is an achievement of the valiant Iraqi resistance, and then it is the right of this resistance, which include patriotic, nationalistic, and Islamic fractions representing all spectrums of people. This resistance has identified a general and meticulous framework about dealing with the occupier. By focus on preventing a negotiation with the occupiers, no matter how long it takes and how much sacrifices they have to pay, until the criminal occupiers recognizes Iraqi rights as laid down, including A, complete and unconditional withdrawal from Iraq. B, resistance with its known picture is the sole legitimate representative of the people of Iraq. C, release all prisoners and detainees without exception. D, rebuild Iraq's army and the forces of national security in accordance with its laws and the traditions of their national well-known job, and away from the sectarian, ethnic, and regional distribution. And FE, recognition of the occupier on its major guilty, a crime of the century, which is the occupation of the Iraq. These came under lies and justifications that are proven by his conviction to be false, and take responsibility for this crime, and to impose a formal pledge to compensate Iraq for all the injury and result of occupation, and by the actions and the crimes of everyday life. The last one, cancellation of all decisions, laws, and agreements they have entered into and executed for hegemony, domination, blackmail, and theft of wealth and the people's money. Hence, we call our brothers and leaders of Islamic countries and all free people in the Arab and Islamic nation, and all freedom fighters and philanthropists in the world, those who are calling for the right and raise the values of the truth and the freedom and justice, and through all their parties, political, popular, and professional communities, to stand all to support the people of Iraq, the people who like peace and freedom, and to assist their valiant resistance to eradicate the occupation and its allies. We also call on the nation's leaders to provide support to the people of Iraq to get rid of the clutches of the occupation and its results, because if it become able to implement its project and the program in Iraq, it will be able to undermine other countries of the nation. We also call for the hard work